Fun Channel, it's Fun Factory, and today we are reviewing the MX500, a Razor electric dirt bike, and we're going to ride it in the dirt and see how it goes.
Yeah, it's an off-road Razor. If you haven't seen his video before, he has the Razor that's the street bike version. It's a battery-powered electric bike, and this is a battery-powered electric bike slash motorcycle, and we'll let you guys know what we actually think of it.
Okay, that's good.
There it goes. It looks like a wheel.
Alright, so there's a tire right there. Oh my goodness. So this is an air-filled pneumatic tire. As you can see, it got like a little air thingy there, so that's how you know if it's pneumatic or not. So here it is, the MX500, and well, we're just taking it out right now.
Looks like it's mainly put together.
Yeah.
You need to put on the front tire and fasten the handlebars.
Mm-hmm.
What else comes with it? Looks like the front fender.
Yep. Oh, also got the same thing as the RSF650.
Okay.
Got the
front fender.
Yep. Also got a footrest right here. Right there. Has the same thing as the
RSF. Inside
the fender.
Alright, so they said we don't have to order any kind of tools. They say everything comes in this bag, but we're going to go ahead and see. I did have extra tools I brought upstairs just in case. Always make sure you have safety equipment when you order these electric bikes. This one supposedly goes 15 miles per hour. I'll put all the stats and the cost below. This one we got off of Sam's Club online. It was $500, $499. I'll put the price below. But normally the price for this kind of a scooter is $650, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
You go to Amazon.
All right, so we're gonna put on these handlebars right here. Just take that out. Oh yeah,
it does
need tools, yeah.
So,
this thing is resting on me.
Came in the little plastic bag, looks like the charging port. We'll figure out where that goes. Looks like the clamp for the handlebars. And it looks like little tools, Allen wrenches. It looks like we have everything here to put the rest of the bike together, but we're just gonna go ahead and see, okay?
Assembled, we got the handlebar assembled, and we also got the front tire right here assembled. Right now I'm wearing my pads just for the safety, so
safety first.
Yep, safety first.
Looks like the other Razor comes with a full charge. On the other Razor scooter, it had shocks, faux shocks. They were just a solid piece of aluminum.
Yeah.
This actually has a shock in the front, which is cool. It's got dual disc brakes, one in the front, also one in the back here, which is really a great feature. I love that. And in the back, you can see that rear shock. The RSF 650 had a rear shock very similar to this, but the front shock was not a real shock, and it allowed for really hard bumps, so it was made for street. This one actually, as you saw in the video, he went off curves with a lot of absorption, which was kind of cool. The other thing I liked about this was a lighter weight overall. I'll put the weight of the actual bike in the description below. And we added a headlight here, front headlight, which we got off of Amazon. That's just for safety in the evening. Also, we're gonna add some blinker side marker lights as well. All right, so the other bike was a street bike. This one is mainly off-road, which is kind of cool because he can go off curbs, go on the grass without a problem. The other one really had a front suspension problem. It was a solid shock. It looked like a real shock on the RSI 650, but it was just a solid piece of aluminum. It was a faux shock. This shock here has a front and a rear shock, dual disc brakes, which are great. I love the foot pegs here. And also, there is a charging port right here, so you can charge it. The weight of this one is a lot less than the other one. The only thing I don't like, Zayd, the one thing that the negative that I don't like is that this isn't any kind of storage. It's a faux tank. It's not a real gas tank. The other one actually had a compartment, which was cool because you could go to the store and put whatever you wanted in it. Because it's off-road, that's why they didn't make a compartment for it. I do like the fact that the rear wheel is smaller. This is a bit slower than the other one. Today we'll go over the top speed. The one thing I do want to mention, when you put this thing together, make sure, put on this front tag, the number 4 tag first, because we made the mistake and tried to put this on afterwards and the screws under here, and I tried to get your hand under here and try to screw this thing in from the top and the bottom. It was a real pain in the neck. You have to assemble the front tire, so it's easy to put on this name tag first. The other thing I have to mention is this one bolt that goes through. There's hex nuts on both sides, so you're gonna need 2 wrenches. The wrenches that came with it, they're really chintzy. They're not good wrenches at all, and they're like kind of toys. They're like thin pieces of aluminum, so you really can't get a gorilla grip and monkey down on it. You really can't torque down on it very much because the tools that were provided, yes, they provide all the tools that we need to put this thing together, but if you have your own tools, I believe this one hex nut is like a 16 millimeter. The other one is like an 18. There's 2 different sizes. Don't ask me why, but they're 2 different sizes. So you have to hold on to one while you crank down the other one, torque it down to get it really snug. We found that out because after he rode it for the first time, the front wheel was a little bit loose. So those tools, they're good to get you going, but if you really want to torque it down and get the right specs, you're gonna need your own tools. The ones they provide are just the basic ones, just to kind of put it together haphazardly, I guess.
All right, so the RSF 650, is a little faster. This one only goes 15 on like a teenager, but on me it goes about like 17, 18. So my weight is about 47 pounds. And on this, it goes about like 17 miles per hour. But on a normal teenager, it'll go like 15. So yeah, it's a little bit slower.
What about the acceleration?
The acceleration actually is better on this one than the RSF 650.
I'll put the weight specs in the description below, but this one is a lot lighter than the other one.
Yeah, so this one tops out very fast compared to the RSF 650. The RSF 650 will keep accelerating for like a couple 10 seconds.
Yeah, like I mentioned before, we're going to put some side marker lights here. We'll put a bell or a horn here. We added the one headlight for safety. We got that off of Amazon. It's quite cheap. The other thing that we'll probably add is a speedometer.
Yep.
One that with a GPS, that way he can tell exactly how fast he's going, up or downhill. But overall, great looking bike. To be honest, the other bike looked better to me. It looks like more of a cool bike.
Yeah.
But this is like got a little off-road look to it. I like it. I wish it had 2 things. I wish it had a real tank, and I wish it came with its own headlights and some mirrors, possibly.
Yep.
But it's an off-road bike, so I guess that's why they didn't add those on.
Talk to me again.
special thoughts about this thing is amazing. You don't feel any single bumps when you go on the grass. Not like the RSF 650 where you feel a ton of bumps.
Well, it has a dual shock system. It looks like it's got a great dual shock system. I'll put all the stats in the description below.
And I'm actually not vibrating so much and jiggling.
Yeah, so you got the dual shocks. You have the front disc brake, rear disc brake. You got the kickstand, obviously, the foot pegs, right?
Yep.
There's no faux container gas tank here,
it's
so
just a fake one.
It's just a fake one, but we'll put headlights on. Mm. It still has a full charge, as you can see. The brake lights are the brake handles are adjustable.
So it comes with pretty good charge. I mean, it goes really fast.
It was pretty easy to assemble, so just read the instructions. All the tools came with it that you need, so
yep.
That was cool. It looks like a little alternator down there. The disc brakes look cool. Here's the rear shock. Back there, I don't know if you can see it, goes back in there.
Yep.
Here's a better angle. So that rear shock helps support. You can adjust the shock up and down if you want. It looks like there's a way to do that. So you like it compared to the other one, street bike.
All right, so this thing has a much better turn radius. Plus, it stops a little faster and it doesn't squeak when it stops. Yeah, and honestly, it just flies and has a lot more horsepower. Just, you don't even press the throttle too much. It goes voop, voop.
We'll add the speedometer on there so you can see exactly how fast you're going.
And thanks for watching. If you want to see more videos, make sure to like, subscribe, add a comment, and hit the notification bell. And I'll see you next episode.